wants to massacre him.
Go on out there and kill him.
Wipe them out. All of them. To the very last man. Violence. Brutality.
Trigger traitors are all dead. Take a walk in the cemetery.
Get eaten up by cannibals.
Celebrate Halloween.
Finn Darnell, what is going on, my friends?
How are you doing tonight?
I'm exhausted myself. Flying solo with my daughter while my wife and son are away. So working and taking care of her, man. Enjoying one of my favorite beers this time of year. Tasty Yingling, Hershey's Porter. Love this beer so much. And I hate Hershey's chocolate. I think Hershey's chocolate tastes like dog shit. I also hate milk chocolate. But, man, I took a chance on this beer. I don't know, it had to be 2-3 years ago when it first came out. Beer is really, really good. Holy shit, how is it going? Glad to see someone from DLive. I occasionally Bridget comes in. My last few streams, I haven't seen her, though. Alright, so we don't got a theme going on tonight. We're just going to play what looks good, and what looks good right now is a twofer from Life of Agony. Anybody has any band requests, go ahead, throw them up in the chat. I'll get to them. You know, I was lucky enough to see these guys on the 20th anniversary tour of the River Runs Red album, where they played this album in its entirety. One of the best shows I ever went to. Yeah, man, the 20th anniversary show of this album, it was one of the best shows I had ever seen. They played at Starland Ballroom here in Jersey. Just awesome show. And to see it with the original band, because, Keith Caputo did leave the band after, it was the second or third album. And then the singer from Ugly Kid Joe came in and did a couple albums with Life of Agony before Caputo came back. But now I don't really have any interest in seeing them anymore because they don't sound the same since Keith Caputo became Mina Caputo. You know, whatever. If they're happy, I don't care, but the band does not sound the same anymore. Alright, how about we get a little down, we get a little dirty. There's no better way to get just filthy than with Guar. We're gonna keep it rolling with Guar, do a little block here.
Let's go. could only be evil, senseless slaughter of the gutter slime that litters this nation for cash and prizes. Yes, this is the show where people bet their lives to win something big. Cause when your life is shit, then you haven't got much to lose on Snotty Road. Hide money from a hippie. Put it under the soap. I'm sorry, but that answer wasn't in time. You're gonna have to put your mouth on this. Oh, I blew your head clean off. Good thing I was such an expert shot with the National Guard back in Kent State. I begged for that day. There's nothing like hippie, honey. My dad always used to take me along with Lee Harvey Oswald.
This was so on point for Guar back in the early days, you know? You know, I wish I could have saw Guar in the 90s. I think that would have been an insane show to go to. I saw Guar plenty of times in like the 2000s and the 10s. I saw them at Sounds of the Underground with Testament. I saw them at the Wellmont Theater in Montclair with fucking Lamb of God. Really fun shows, but you gotta kind of stand away from the stage, otherwise you're gonna get douched in fake blood and just all the shit that they would spray out onto the crowd. Yeah, Guar was always a really fun show, and back then I actually wasn't really big into their music, though. When I caught them with Lamb of God, it was during their Lust in Space tour, and I happened to pick up Lust in Space, and I fell in love with the album, and that's how I really got into Guar, is from fucking... like their, what was that, their 7th or 8th album? I'll play a Lamb of God song, sure. Absolutely. But right now we're gonna jump into some Anthrax here. I'm actually not the biggest Anthrax fan, you know, and which is weird considering they are thrash metal and they're East Coast thrash metal, but I just never really got into them like a lot of other bands. I don't know. They had just a sound that by the time I started to listen to them, I was so deep into Bay Area thrash that listening to Anthrax, it was so fucking weird. You know, it wasn't, because they don't sound like Overkill, which is obviously East Coast thrash. They don't sound like Death Thrash, which is East Coast thrash. They really had their very own unique sound. And it, you know, to this day, I can't say that I love Anthrax, but I will say that their 2011 release of Worship Music is by far one of the best albums from the 2010s. And we're going to listen to one of my favorite tracks from that album right now.
Whoa.
such a dumbass.
No.
We consume the multi-hoppy beverages of the alcoholic kind on this stream. No G Fuel. We took it back to 2000 here with this Lamb of God. Off the new American Gospel album. Just a powerful, fucking brutal album through and through. One of my favorite albums they've done. They actually don't put out bad albums, per se. But New American Gospel. Man, this album is it's brutality at its finest. Yeah, definitely look into this album. It's so goddamn good. One, probably my favorite Lamb of God song right there. All right. Before we continue with the metal beer update, drinking one of my favorites. I had bought a case before they stopped selling it for the year of my Kirkland Citra Hop Session IPA. Love this beer. It's a summertime beer. So, once the fall hits, they obviously don't sell it anymore until next season. Just a great beer. Very easy session IPA. Very mild in terms of hoppiness and alcohol percentage, 4.9. So, I could drink like 40 of these and all I'd be doing is peeing. But, tonight we got... Got a lot of great familiar faces in chat. Thank you guys for hanging out, thrashing with me. I love it so much. You guys mean the world to me. You don't know. I am trying to stream a bit more regularly. I know it's been about a week or two since my last stream, but as I was saying before, my wife, she's actually in Asia with my son for business and visiting some family over there. So it's just me and the little girl flying solo right now. So usually by the end of the day when I'm done with work, I'm just hanging out with her, taking care of her. And by the end of the day, I'm just like, I don't have just the energy or drive to get here and sometimes do this. But, I kind of laid down earlier with her and caught like a second wind today. So that's why we're here tonight. Oh, I'm good, man. I am good. So we ain't going anywhere yet. The night is young and we still got more thrashing to do. Now, last night, speaking of bands that I have actually never seen live, last night, had my wife been home to watch the kids, I would have finally have gone to see Municipal Waste. They were playing actually down in Asbury Park last night. I've never seen them live. Every time I'm on the precipice of seeing them live, something fucking happens and I don't get to go. Such is life. So, I don't know. Not celebrate, but because I'm talking about municipal waste, we're going to play some municipal waste. As many of you know, crossover thrash metal is just some of my favorite thrash metals, just some of my favorite metal in general. And looking at their set list, we are going to play the last two songs that they play to close their set. Both songs off the 2007 masterpiece, The Art of Partying. Because we're having a party here tonight. So, who better to join the party than the members of Municipal Waste? And here is the title track from that album. You guys have not checked out their latest album, the 2022's Electrified Brain album. Check it out. It is a fucking banger, which is a, it is so refreshing considering their last two albums were really not that good. But Electrified Brain, it's a fucking, it's solid. It is a good goddamn album. So before we jump into a bit of Overkill, we're going to stay on the crossover thrash realm for another song or two. I play this band almost every stream. Love this band. I play this particular song almost every stream just because I don't know, man. It something about this song. It just fucking it hits me. Hits me good. Hits me in that warm metal place deep in the cockles of my heart, you know? Love this band so much. Don't know what is currently going on with this band. I don't know if they're together anymore. It's actually really hard to find information on Dr. Living Dead, as they are a Swedish band, and they never really made it like super mainstream, obviously. But every once in a while, I try to look up information, see what's going on with them. You know, they did put out a bunch of albums, and they're all fantastic albums. So hopefully, you know, maybe they're just taking a break and they come back, and, you know, my hope is maybe one day they come and they do, you know, a U.S. tour. But again, I don't know how many you know, American metalheads actually know about this band. But if you like bands like Municipal Waste and Suicidal Tendencies, these guys are literally just cut from that same cloth. And my favorite song by them, as I said, I play this song almost every single fucking stream because I love it. We'll do a twofer for these guys because they are true crossover thrash. So their songs are only about 1 to 2 minutes each.
frankly, you got a problem with authority.
Taking it back to the East Coast.
You got no fucking idea what it's like to be number one.
Yeah, it's weird that this particular year we get a movie like Violent Night and Christmas Bloody Christmas. Both that look very entertaining. If not, you know, being dumb fun. But, I mean, I got a backlog of movies, you know, I got to watch. I still have to watch X and Pearl. I do want to watch the new Hellraiser, too. I've heard, like it's not bad. And I'm a big fan of the first three Hellraiser movies. I actually really like Hell on Earth. Hellraiser 3. Pretty much every movie after that is dog shit, but... David Harbour is a really good actor, and so is John Leguizamo. So, you know, the ingredients were there for a decent movie. Oh. Well, Peach, Magnum knows all about the ins and outs of disability. Mag knows all about the ins and outs of that world, Peach. Granted, he is from the Great White North, so things might be slightly different up there, but that's still his realm at the end of the day. But yeah, man, I got such a backlog of fucking movies to watch. I don't know when I'll get to them. Hopefully soon. I don't know. Usually at like Monster Mania or a convention, you know, I fucking chug through a lot of movies. But obviously the last Monster Mania, I fucking flew solo the entire weekend. So I was like, I really wasn't in the room much. And when I was in the room, I was just fucking... just vegging out. Like, I wasn't even watching movies. I think I was watching, like, preseason football. And just sort of, like, recharging my batteries. Normally, Monster Mania weekend, you know, I'm with, a couple people, and we're just fucking, we're drinking, we're partying, we're down at the show floor, we're down in the lobby, you know, whatnot. This show... Friday I did drink a lot, but the Saturday portion of the show, which is usually the day where we would watch a lot of movies, I ended up just relaxing and recharging my batteries. Hopefully, come March, you know, things will change. Some of my regular friends who usually, you know, been coming with me to these Monster Mania conventions for years, we'll get back on the horse and, you know, come and hang out and have some fun. But, you know, that's in March. It's months away. Cross that bridge when we get there. But let's get back to the metal right now. How about we play something a bit melodic? I play these guys every once in a while. I like this band. I like the first, like, three albums before they decided... Well, before the original singer left, and then they got two singers, and I really haven't liked the music since. but... They're, I believe...
Their first album? I think it's the first album. First album, first song. one of my favorite. In fact, the first... God. This entire album is almost perfect. It's almost not a bad song on this album. But anyway, here's some Scar Symmetry with The Illusionist. We'll be right back. Really cool band. If you like sort of that melodic, I guess I would call Scar Symmetry sort of melodic industrial. First three albums, Pitch Black Progress, Dark Matter Dimensions, great albums. All right, we're going to listen to something a little bit different here. This is an artist, a German artist, and he's got aspects of metal to him, but it's very much on the in the electronic realm and sort of gothic realm, but it's got a really, really cool sound. I discovered him years and years ago. I think he's retired. I don't think he makes music and tours anymore. I haven't actually really followed his career in the last few years. But I'd come across some of his music. God, we're going back 10, 11, 12 years now. On this particular album, I happened to find it. And I was listening to it. And I'm listening, and I'm like, wow, this guy sounds like Till Lindemann. What are we watching? This is Haxan from like the 1920s witchcraft movie. Fucking one of my favorite movies. Public domain, so I can sit there and play it, and YouTube can't bitch at me about it. It's just about like witchcraft and shit. You'll see like this scene right here. The scene you're watching right here, this is from like some white zombie videos and stuff, Rob Zombie videos and stuff. It's just like old witchcraft movies. It's just fucking cool. The imagery and costumes and all that stuff from the time. It's fucking so cool. thank you for swinging by, Apple. Always a pleasure seeing you. anyway, so this band. When I first heard them years ago, a decade ago, I'm listening to them. I'm like, God, this sounds like Till Lindemann. Till Lindemann is the lead singer of Rammstein. So I ended up having to look it up. And, you know, obviously it was not Till Lindemann. We're going to listen to some Till after this, though, because since we're doing the whole German thing. but anyway, this is slightly out of the hard, you know, heavy metal realm into the more of the melodic metal realm, electronic and gothic. Really, really catchy stuff. Really, I don't know. A lot of his music is just hits you right where you need to be hit, and it's sort of, I wouldn't say soothing is the right word, but it is, like, sometimes this type and style of music is what you need, even though you didn't know you needed it, if that makes any sense. Regardless, we're going to do a twofer from this guy. His name is Unheilig, as I said, German guy. Sings primarily in German. Even though I think he did do a couple songs in English, but not many. we're going to do a twofer from this guy off his 2010 album, Groß Freiheit. And I hope you guys like it. As I said, this isn't super heavy stuff. It's not really metal. It borderlines that kind of metal world, but it's really, I don't know, just it's cool stuff, and I hope you dig it. We'll be right back.
mehr sehen.
Ich war glücklich.
Ich hab gedacht, du wärst fort. Warum kommst du? Du wolltest doch gehen.
Ich will dich.
Ich will nicht hören, was du denkst und wie scheinbar schlecht du mich siehst.
Es verletzt mich,
wenn du alles zerreißt, nur weil ich nicht so bin, wie du mich willst. Glaub mir, ich achte mich und werd mein Leben weiterleben und nicht Träume wegen dir übersehen. Ich vergesse dich, ich sage dir Lebewohl und kann mit Stolz in den Spiegel sehen. Was du willst, sodass die Wahrheit chancenlos ist.
Du glaubst nicht,
ich hab mir mein Glück verdient, auch wenn du selber niemals glücklich bist.
Du brauchst mich,
du lenkst nur davon ab, um zu verschleiern, wie schwach du wirklich bist.
Du belügst mich,
wenn du sagst, ich gönn es dir, obwohl du weißt, dass das gelogen ist. Träume sollen Segel sein, sie zeigen dir, wohin es geht. Ich sage dir jetzt, lebe wohl, weil du sie nicht mehr siehst. Ich gehöre nur mir. Ich gehöre mir ganz allein.
Fällt mir schwer, ohne dich zu leben, jeden Tag zu jeder Zeit einfach alles zu geben. Ich denk so oft zurück an das, was war, an jedem so geliebten vergangenen Tag. Ich stell mir vor, dass du zu mir stehst und jeden meiner Wege an meine Seite gehst. Ich denke an so vieles, seitdem du nicht mehr bist. Denn du hast mir gezeigt, wie wertvoll das Leben ist. Wir waren geboren, um zu leben, mit den Wundern jener Zeit. Sich niemals zu vergessen, bis in alle Ewigkeit. Wir waren geboren, um zu leben, für den einen Augenblick, bei dem jeder von uns spürte, wie wertvoll Leben ist. Es tut noch weh, wieder neuen Platz zu schaffen, mit gutem Gefühl etwas Neues zuzulassen. In diesem Augenblick bist du mir wieder nah, wie an jedem so geliebten vergangenen Tag.
Right, we're going to stay in Germany with lead singer of Rammstein, Till Lindemann's latest solo single.
Während sie liest und dabei einen Apfel isst. Der liebe Herrgott will mich strafen, die Nervensäge will nicht schlafen, hört überhaupt nicht auf zu schreien. Der Vater schläft längst wie ein Stein. Hier die Frage aller Klassen, kann und muss man Kinder hassen? Ich hasse Kinder! Ich hasse Kinder. Nein, ich liebe sie. Ja, ich liebe sie. Die Großen und die Kleinen, doch es müssen meine sein.
Wow. Not Rammstein. Close enough to Rammstein. And man, it's just, every time I listen to Rammstein now, I think back to seeing them live again this past September and just having the absolute most fun in my life. I can't remember the last time I had so much fun at a concert. Tailgating the way we did. I got so drunk. Despite getting kind of messed up, I ended up falling on my face from being so drunk. I took an elbow to my schnoz. I was fucking sneezing, blowing out blood for days. That was not because I was drunk. I happened to be in the pit, and I took an elbow to the nose, to the schnoz, you know. But we had this massive tailgate because we had a tent with us, me and my buddy who went. It's a really cool song. We had a tent with us, me and my friend, the tailgate, and nobody else there, well, not many people there had brought tents, and it was pouring all day. So what I ended up doing is I was walking around the parking lot, and I'm seeing people in their cars. I'm fucking banging on the window. I'm like, yo, get out of your fucking car. Come to the tent. I'm like, I got fucking food. I got coolers of beer. I'm like, you come. You fucking party with us. When everything was said and done, I probably had about 20 to 30 people under my tent. From all different countries, man. We had people from Uruguay, Germany. We had people from Spain and Portugal. Fucking everywhere under my fucking tent. And everybody was drinking and partying, and I had music fucking blasting, and I was fucking grilling, and oh my God. Like, every once in a while, I need a day like that. Now, again, I got really, really, really drunk. Not like, I guess I got sloppy to a degree, because as I was cleaning up, you know, I was trying to get my grill put away and everything, I lost my balance and I fell, boom, fucking face first into the gravel. And one of the guys that's partying with us, I called him Muscles, because fucking, hang on. I'll show you why I called him Muscles. He picked me up and, he's like, "You all right, man?" I'm like, "Yeah, I'm fine." I'm like, "Why? What's wrong?" He's like, "Dude," he goes, "your fucking face is covered in blood." I didn't feel anything. But I'd cut my forehead and, my nose and just my face. It was all covered in blood. He took a picture and showed me. I don't have that picture, but that's Muscles there. He picked me up off the ground when I fucking face planted. And then this guy here, that's my buddy Anthony. I've known him for years. So despite face planting and cutting up my face and scratching up my glasses and everything, it was like just one of the most just fun times, man. You know, it's just, and then I realized at that point, that like, I need that every once in a while. You know, I got my wife, I got my kids, I love them to death, and I need them in my life every day. But every once in a while, I need that little break. I need that little break. I don't need much, just that little break. And just going out, just getting stupid, listening to metal, fucking barbecuing, drinking beer, and just having the fucking time of my life at one of the most insane fucking metal shows you can go to. And I'll tell you what, that's a big boy. Oh, bro, Muscles, when he first came over, I'm like, oh man, this guy looks like a massive asshole. Dude, he was the nicest fucking guy in the world. I love that guy. I wish I could remember what his name was. He told me his name. I was so goddamn drunk. I was drinking fucking New Belgium Voodoo Ranger Juice Forces all fucking day. And those things were like 9% alcohol. I wish I could remember his name, but I don't. So he's Muscles to me, and he was the coolest guy ever, and we partied, and he would actually help me clean up and get shit back in my car. Man. But when I go to shows like that and I tailgate and I party and I drink, I do all my partying and drinking at the tailgate. And when I get into the show, I don't drink anymore. So I'm good to drive home by the end of the night. Because, you know, you're talking about, three plus hours before you're fucking out of there and back to your car. Man, that's why I hope Rammstein comes around again, because that was one of the most epic tailgates I have ever thrown in my life. I know my friend who was with me, he needed that day as much as I did. And, you know, like, if I could do something like that once a year, even once every other year, I feel like I could keep myself balanced and leveled. Like, I can't explain it. It's just that bit of like life force that you need just to kind of replenish your soul a bit. Don't have to worry about the kids. Don't have to worry about the wife. You just go, you do your thing for that day. And then you come home and then you go back to, you know, the real world. Yeah, it's just. So good. I have such. Despite being as drunk as I was at the show, I have such fucking awesome memories. Like, I remember so much of that show. I don't remember names. And again, I met so many people there. So many people from so many different countries coming to party and eat and drink with us. But we were all there in the name of metal. And man, if I can do that again soon. I can't wait. All right. Enough of me blabbering here. About a little punk. A little punk. Kind of niche punk. But punk I like. How about a threefer from the green ones?
The bear went over the mountain to see what he could see. The other side of the mountain was all there. I like that, Peach.
All right, let's round out this threefer with one more from the green ones. No other song makes me laugh and rock out as hard and as much as that song does. Something a little bit more melodic.
I'm the breaker of all.
are traveling the world here tonight on Metal Mayhem Radio. And as I said, we are on our way to the mysterious subcontinent of India, where a very unique Indian folk metal band resides. Aspects of this band I do not like, but there is more than enough of this band that I do like that I put up with the stuff that I don't like. That made sense. You just might not have followed it. This is Bloodywood with Gada. Trust me on this one. Guy who sings in Punjabi on this band, one of the best singers I have heard in my entire life.
More than a rap man, we're reforming governments. Full on attack, man, get with the plan. We're here to pull apart the politicians and the God plan. Yeah, we're slaying, but we're saying nothing new. We're just saying you better do the shit you say you're gonna do. None of that fake shit, WWE, cause you know we keep it real like the UFC,
Man, I can play this whole fucking album. Their debut album from this year. It's called Rock Shock. Again, the band is Bloody Wood. Fucking such a good band. Check out the album. Check out the band. They fucking toured. I'm so fucking mad. They toured the United States. I could have went and fucking saw them, but I was in Florida at the time that they were playing up here, up in my area, in the New York, New Jersey area. I missed them because I was on fucking vacation with the family in Florida. So mad. So mad. Hopefully they come back. Hopefully they come back. They put out another album. They come back. I can see them and I can die happy because, like, love this band. All right. We're going to move. We're going from Japan to India, and now we're going to Poland. This band's a little different. A little different from what I normally play. Black metal. Not traditional black metal, though. So this band, don't try to understand what they're saying, because they don't sing in English, and they don't sing in Polish. This particular band sings in a dialect of, like, old Slavic. Right? And it's not even just, like an old... It's just not, like, Slavic. It's, like, an old dialect version of Slavic. So, I don't know how many people actually understand what they're singing about. It's black metal, so obviously anything they're singing about is religious. They're sort of a theatrical band. But this particular band has been through a lot of turmoil over the last few years. There's now two different versions of this band. It's a nightmare if you happen to be a big fan of this band. I'm not sure how I found them, like 2-3 years ago, but I did. And I appreciate what they're trying to do. It's very different. It's very unique. We're going to be listening to a track off their 2015 album. I'm not even going to try to fucking pronounce the name of the album. But the name of the band is Batshuka. And, well, on their albums, they don't actually have names of the songs. It's just one name and then the track number. So, like, for this particular album, there's eight tracks on the album, and each track is named Yekpenya. I don't know what the fuck that means. But, you know, it's just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on and so on. Again, very unique black metal band. This song is pretty cool. It's got a really cool riff to it, really good groove, and I think you guys will dig it. I love this song a lot. A lot of their other stuff I'm not huge into. I mean, they do have some good stuff, but this particular song, this one's always stood out to me. Really cool track. I hope you guys dig it. Man, that is such a cool track. It's almost like Gregorian singing in the background with just a driving riff up front. Oh, it's so cool. So cool. Really really a unique band, Batshuka. You know, I can't say that all of their stuff sounds like that, but that particular track is choice. Fucking choice. All right, as I said, we're going to keep on with a bit more black metal here, but we're going to keep with the uniqueness of the black metal genre. You know, black metal can be a little too brutal for some people, a little too distorted and messy. And personally, I'm not into that type of black metal. I love Venom. Venom, Nocturnal Mortem. I mean, Valkyrie is one of my all-time favorite songs. But black metal is such a very diverse subgenre of metal. And it's become so diverse that black metal itself has branched off into different subgenres. That one was, I don't even know what you would call Batshuka. I don't know, old Polish church black metal? I don't know. That fucking band is in a genre of its own. This next band, they're from Illinois. This next one is, they fall into a subgenre called psychedelic black metal. I'll let you try to figure out whatever the fuck that means. But they got some really cool music. We're going to do a twofer off their 2010 album here. Name of this band is Nock Mystium. Really, really unique band. Really, I don't know if I would call them accessible, but it's like some of their stuff is sort of easy to get into, despite being on the really fucking weird end of the spectrum of metal, especially black metal. Anyway, we're going to check out two tracks off their 2010 album, Addicts of Black Metal, Part 2. First track we're going to listen to is called No Funeral, followed by one of my favorite tracks called Addicts. Hope you guys dig this, because, as I said, it is different, but it's really fucking cool.
We're going to be hanging out for a little while longer. So hopefully you guys can continue to hang out with me, enjoy some of the music. I just wanted to, you know, just say thank you for spending your night with me. You don't know how much it means to me. I love to just play music for you guys, stuff you might know and love, stuff you might not have ever heard of before. That's the whole idea behind the stream, behind what I'm doing here. And you know, again, you don't know how much it means to me just for you guys to be hanging out. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you for just being here with me. You know, most of you guys have, you know, been to streams I've done for a couple years now, even though I'm not very reliable when it comes to streaming. But regardless, you guys are awesome, and you're the reason why I like doing this. And obviously, you enjoy it as well. Otherwise, you wouldn't be wasting your fucking time with me. So thank you so much. We're doing one more from these guys, Knock Misty, I'm off the same album. This is track number 6 off that particular album. This one's called Addicts. And if you liked that last song, No Funeral, you will love this song. This is my favorite song by them. And it one of my all-time favorite songs. Oddly enough, from such a just a weird random band. But this song, if you like the last one, man, trust me on this one.
Always a pleasure, Bridget. Thank you for hanging out, jamming with us. Hopefully I'll see you again soon. But we are not done here tonight. We're going to hang out for a little while longer. We're going to play some more stuff. Right now, we're going to dive into some new Ozzy. After Ozzy's previous album, Ordinary Man, I did not think he really had much left in the tank. That album was the worst thing he's ever put out. Despite the two singles off that album being two of the best singles he's ever put out, Under the Graveyard and the title track, Ordinary Man, with Elton John. By far, some of the best singles he's ever done. But the rest of the album was absolute dog shit, which is, that's just not like Ozzy. So I didn't have too high of a hopes for Patient Number 9. Obviously, the title track dropped, Patient Number 9. And I was like, all right, this is a really good track. And then Degradation Rules, which was a song he did with Tony Iommi. I'm like, oh, all right, this is really good too. And every time I heard a new song, you know, another, what was the other single? Mr. Darkness. I think that was with Zakk Wylde. Fuck. Yeah, we might have a good album on our hands. And lo and behold, we got a fucking good album. A really good album. Like, insanely good compared to what he put out previously. Right now, we're going to check out a track that he did with Eric Clapton. It might be my favorite track on the album. Awesome. Awesome song. Hope you guys dig this one. Called One of Those Days.
They can tell us we're crazy, and we can say, well, you haven't seen anything yet.
I've been deep into the metal catalog, baby.
Thank you.
Dio is an entity. An entity that will probably never be duplicated in the world of metal. From his humbling beginnings in Ronnie and the Red Tops to very underrated 2 Elf albums to obviously the immortal Rainbow with 3 of the best metal albums ever to obviously Black Sabbath and ushering in that particular era, unique era of Black Sabbath, to doing his own thing in his band. Dio is an entity. There will be many like him. None will come close to what he achieved. The way he sounds, the way he presented himself on stage. I was lucky enough to see Dio live 12 times. I saw him with Sabbath. I saw him solo with his band during the Killing the Dragon tour. I saw it was Motorhead opening, then Dio came on, and then it was Iron Maiden. And I think it was the Killing the Dragon tour for Dio, and it was, I'm pretty sure it was the Brave New World tour for Iron Maiden. And that particular show, well, I mean, a lot of the Dio solo shows, that was the only one I ever got to see, but he would always play Rainbow songs, and I was lucky enough to, you know, to see him play, you know, Stargazer and Man on the Silver Mountain and Long Live Rock and Roll live. You know, I'd never seen those songs live, let alone live fucking Dio singing them. And I was lucky enough to see Heaven and Hell 2-3 times. I saw them with Judas Priest. I saw them... Well, that Judas Priest show, I think it was Testament opening, and then it was Judas Priest, and then it was Heaven and Hell. It was like the most insane metal itinerary like I've ever been to. Man. The only metal itinerary that could top that for me would be Testament, Suicidal Tendencies, either Destruction or Overkill, and Hyrax. You give me a show with those bands on it, and you're never giving me a better show in my life. But let's continue this. Let's dive a little deeper into the Dio catalog. It's the best word for it. That was a great Rainbow song. Self-Portrait, I believe, is a super underrated track in the Rainbow realm. Let's move forward a little bit. Let's look into some Black Sabbath here. And obviously, everybody knows, you know, Neon Knights, Children of the Sea, Voodoo, Sign of the Southern Cross, Turn Up the Night. These are all huge Sabbath songs from the Dio era. But there are some songs that aren't, that just never caught on like some of the others. And I feel like it's sort of people are missing out.
one of my favorite Dio era Sabbath songs is this one. You know what? YouTube is acting a fucking fool. But you know what? I went longer than I thought I was going to go. Yeah. You know, DLive just never took off. The fact that it's actually still around is kind of awesome. But regardless, YouTube is doing its thing, so it's time to start winding down for the evening. And so I will leave us with three songs.
obviously our end song that I play at the end of every stream I do. Another song that always works a way into my stream, because I love the song and I wish more people need to hear the song. And this next song that I really like, it's not the band's heaviest song, it's not the band's best song, but I loved this song when it came out, 3 years ago. Really catchy song. But, you know, Lordy, a lot of Lordy's music is super catchy. But this particular song, I always loved it. Always loved it from the first time I heard it a few years ago. And, I don't know. Just a fun little song with a really nice Vincent Price homage.
Wish
that's a fun one. A lot of Lordy stuff is really fun. Alright, we are winding down now that YouTube took us down. Though we lasted very long tonight. So I honestly can't complain about YouTube. But we got two more songs left. We're going to move on to one of my favorite songs ever. Love this song. Even though it is a cover, but it's a much... This version is a much superior version to the original. The original version is awful. But this version is fantastic. And it is sung by the one, the only, the absolutely immortal Brendan Fraser. Yes. I say this every time I play this fucking song, which is every fucking stream I do. Yes, Brendan Fraser can sing. He did sing, and he sang good. Deal with it. Love that bass line.
Yeah.
Can't get enough of this song, guys. Thank you all who are still around. Mag, Bridget, Ari, Trina, Nuck, everybody. Thank you guys so much for hanging out tonight. We had just an amazing turnout. Apple. Got Apple. You know, just an amazing turnout tonight. You guys don't know what it means to me. Maybe we will do it again tomorrow night. Who knows? But thank you so much. And until next time, keep the horns up. Keep the beer cold. Keep the heads thrashing. And be good.